the beginning of the Cousins treat, retreat trip, 1996 in Kansas City Airport. Bill, Amanda, Brian, and Angie met us, and Mary came to see us at the airport. Isn't she beautiful? She's walking. Mary and Tiffany, Spencer. Who's all these family members? The t-shirt. Cousins Tour 96, lest we forget. James Paul. Very good, very good. Here's Mary getting ready to do some high stepping. Here she comes. She's really moving out fast. She's gonna do it. She's gotta have her binky. There she comes. Whoa, what's her go to mom? Kitty, Marie.
Nice try. Anyone else?
Yeah. Here, I can watch.
Our mom was waiting for all the sluggish.
Look over here at the picture.
Grandma.
Grandma. They took our picture. They took our picture.
Been a little cooler here last couple of days.
Here we are following the tour bus.
We're like you could call us the tail end of the tour. See, we are the tail end of the tour. Yes, it is.
It's the baby kiss. Look at that.
Looks good.
Give the baby kiss.
Mama, can I have a kiss? No. Yeah, can I have a kiss? You know what the killer whale?
Yeah.
It's slimed.
Apple.
Good.
And what? Where do you think we are, Angie?
We're in Liberty.
Liberty. Mom eating her garlic shrimp she brought all the way from Mesa, Arizona.
It was worth it.
Much to the chagrin of the passengers, but very tasty to us. Plane did a little swerving on the way here when the garlic was released. Kind of like pepper spray.
Do it back. Do it back. Do it back, you'll choke. What a mess.
Now, was she walking this well when before Jim left?
No, she's been walking like this for 2 days.
She'll be really surprised. Since when you went on your family church history tour, all you got was pictures of Mary. See, what that's the purpose. For the doggies.
The doggies say, ruff, 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 ruff. Hey, doggy. What's that?
Doggy,
doggy, doggy.
I heard doggy. That. Just going all over now.
Yes, she is the
Sir Dad going to be surprised. See, nothing will be up too high now.
Go, go.
Kansas City baseball game.
Tonight's Don King and Chevrolet Geo feature takes a look at everybody knows that to win baseball games, it takes a bit of skill and a lot of luck. That's why baseball players are some of the most superstitious athletes around. So the Royal Diamond Sports crew went undercover trying to bring up some of the team's most secret superstition. But it wasn't easy. If a player gives away his superstition, his luck may run dry. Good luck charms are a huge hit.
Chilling out with Amanda and Hillary here. They're dinky. Where's Mary? pillow hair, sleeping in this morning.
Oh, I know. It's orders like the half of the whole. Amanda, you're in front of the horses.
Amanda,
get
Brian,
the bell on them.
Bill, Adam, and Diamond.
Now you're in front of the cows. There you go.
Okay, on three.
Zion spread herself abroad, and peace was great and pure the rest of Adam and Diamond. Her land was good and greatly blessed beyond all Israel's Canaan. Her fame was known from east to west. Her peace was great and pure the rest of Adam on Diamond. Hosanna to such day to come, the Savior's second coming. When all the earth in glorious bloom affords the saints a holy home, by Adam on Diamond.
Good singing, Amanda.
Yeah, I got sugar.
Miranda.
Drop down or something.
Fourth quarter, Brian.
Can't see
Eddie.
You.
Nobody's
going to
see you.
On your knees.
That's hilarious.
Fourth quarter.
Had a kid.
Had a shoot a kid. Face, it's right here, on.
Eddie, get up.
Face, had a kid. That's the kid.
Quit yelling at my ear.
Smile.
Look at you. Don't look at my ear.
Oh, whoops.
Well,
am I supposed to take some?
Whoa!
Whoa! There.
Oh,
can we bring tags? Oh, yeah, we're all done.
Picture, and then we can read what it says.
Hey, everybody, shut the sign. Here. Hey, watch.
Jacob.
Hey, Jake.
Set to the side a little bit. You're in the way, Jacob, of the letters.
We are at Far West Missouri, temple site.
How did you feel as you put yourself in this position or applied into your life today?
Who are about? Let's run for us.
Oh, what are you going to do? Just walk right in front of them. Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. After going there,
you
can't just go walk through.
their tabernacle or auditorium where they have other meetings.
This is at their world headquarters.
They have general conference there. And the way they just, it's kind of like a republic, more than a church. They come and they vote, and then that's how they make their decisions. And
they send delegates, they don't send officially only for welfare. He is not the head. They have a pastor in charge of a congregation.
And when they did that, then some of the members broke away and started fundamentalist reorganized congregations because they couldn't accept women having the priesthood. And then this is the temple site here, and this is the church of the temple site, which was started by the Hedrickites, and this is their one and only building, and their whole doctrine, I guess, is the temple site. And when the time is right, then we'll probably buy the temple site from them and build the temple. And our visitor center is to the left here.
Oh, there's all the beautiful flowers.
This was the only one, and they stayed right here.
Why did that sign say that the prophet George Smith Jr. dedicated that sign to this temple?
This sign?
Yeah.
It is. This is the sign for the temple that will be built.
This is what we're doing.
The old church is
going to
be built. That's where God told me.
By the time I got
to
know
he's
the god of
that. Well,
reorganized temple.
What up, Billy?
Hey, where's Amanda? They're standing on the temple lot ground, on the reorganized temple. This is holy ground, dedicated by the prophet Joseph Smith to build the temple for the second coming. Currently owned by the reorganized church, the Church of Christ Temple Lot, and the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. This is the reorganized church, like assembly building.
Thank you.
Oh, this is not good.
I'll see you like, watching here.
This is not good. Oh, yeah, go ahead.
Let's not start up with this again, okay?
Mom?
How?
They're laying in the ground.
Here we are in Hannibal, Missouri at the Best Western Hotel. Just chilling out. What a beautiful hotel.
Jacob, why are we searching another
white cheese on the people's bathroom? Okay. This is a great place.
This is beautiful.
We don't just stay here, we can go out from here. And I said, we should do a day trip.
I will.
And the Grand Poobah.
The Grand Poobah in his brass bed.
Brass bed, yeah.
Right.
Let's see.
Underneath the riverboat.
Turn it back, and then it's on.
Well, he's not a riverboat queen. He's a riverboat king.
I'm getting my picture taken.
Yeah, that's what
we
I said.
We could get a bunch of us on here.
I said more people could sit.
Oh, what a fantastic room.
This is life.
The bathroom isn't any larger, so you can have it. It was a bigger bathroom last time.
We're not going to spend time in there. This is where we spend time out here and lounging with our buddies.
That's it.
Oh, too nice.
And the There's the bridge going across the mighty bridge Mississippi.
So what's the plan for you people? Or are you just...
Here's where we're having breakfast then. Tomorrow.
What's the what?
Well, I want to go to shopping.
Shops.
Probably.
Our room.
All right.
Mighty Mississippi. This is our bus. The Western Trails. It's Mary packing.
Unpacking.
We're gonna be here one night.
Yeah.
Cool. Cool, Bill. Cool, Brian. Here's Matt shooting us, and we're shooting him, but we drew first, so he's dead.
Listen to that.
Yeah.
hear the train?
The sounds of Mark Twain's voice.
Town Hannibal. Getting ready to take the tour.
Did you find her? Maybe.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. So it was there? Here are some tourists.
This side's in the shade, but I have to keep them when we turn the corner.
It was just like being on our bus, backing up.
Per day. He may be the mole at no cost. But the building here is just so the peace
30 seconds. The 30-second man.
We would like is those other little shops.
Mark Twain Cave area.
Yeah.
How about that's right here?
I'd like
This is gorgeous.
You see how big the river is, and you see how small the trees look. Move over here a bit, though.
Yeah.
Could
you get a picture of
us
out there
real quick?
Can
we run off?
It's like
having
fun.
Yeah.
We
are. I don't want to take a picture of you guys.
You should, I guess. Sure.
Wow, it
would
have been perfect. I brought it. Little
boys. Not in Mississippi. Great. Riverview Park, Hannibal, Missouri. Mark, statue of Mark Twain.
What you're looking at, folks, is Illinois. It's got 44,000 acres. 12 to 14, 12, 15. All the way almost to the Russian.
Wow.
You see these side second story houses?
93, 93,
yes, sir.
It's going over to Illinois.
What makes this so dirty? When everybody dumps their sewage in it from Milwaukee South. Yes, they do. In fact, the state or the federal government, the state has asked people not even swim in it this year or eat the fish out of it.
Big barges.
It's here too. And then you read. So much chemicals.
Oh, Homie standing right, the third home of Big Petty Bones, and it dates to 1911. It is now a bed and breakfast. Talk flip side in, and you may view it by appointment.
Wow.
This description found up is the second oldest federal building in Missouri. Was our post office at one time was set of offices upstairs. They will be at 6:30 and that's the best.
Hey Ben, how much do you charge?
Well,
is that what this is?
What? I call chickens fish. I don't show my cleavage.
You look like a school teacher.
That dress doesn't even show cleavage.
That's right.
No, Lisa, what are you doing?
Look at Lisa.
She's not doing
I'm trying to put them up the shoulder, but they just went.
I didn't put on my shoes and socks.
Yes. I'll be over preaching.
No.
Okay, you got to turn around, Jill, so we can see you here.
We are. We're
going to the planet.
Let's get one side coming out.
All right.
Yeah, you
woo! Yeah, that was about really nice. Got it.
Better stand against the wall.
Looks like a young women's presidency member.
Because they were in style in those days. Go, Patrice.
Oh, stop it.
Let's get a close-up. Yes.
Is this known as the Gas House game? Ready for the dinner cruise. Having a good time.
Oh,
I was supposed to. Yeah, how deep's the water here?
So deep their bodies went in there in the Civil War.
No, you guys aren't paying attention to the what goes on around here. Who lived here?
Mark Twain.
There you go.
Abe Lincoln floated this river on a flatboat when he's a young man. He and another guy were hired.
How do you know that?
Because I read the books. Okay. And that's the, probably the best thing about being on this river this day is that Abe Lincoln was here one time.
He slept here?
Well, he probably did somewhere on the flatboat going down to Louisiana.
Here we are on the Mississippi River.
He was impressed when I knew that.
Well, we were down there
dancing. Up the lazy river when he started to play. I said, up the lazy river.
Here's Bill on the Mississippi River on the bows boat.
It was great. Yeah.
Okay. Tom and Cynthia, Matt and Kaylin, Mary. Lavelle, you having a good time?
Shaking his head.
You having a good time? That's good. Oh, you're looking good.
Hey, but we've been watching for pieces of 20.
Oh, when the same.
Are the Saints ready?
Ready.
Are the Saints ready?
Ready.
Let's go.
takes new life.
Oh, that wasn't a computer.
I'll tell you a story about it. There's a contractor in Amador County has one of these on his fire truck. He goes to fairs and stuff with it.
There
he
goes. There. Just pour some into the pipe.
I still don't see anything coming out.
Nothing comes out. It's a sad thing. So what happened?
I want to see if we can see Peabody's house. Pettibone.
Pettibone?
Pettibone is a rich vlogger. They could see his log floating down the river. Somebody built a house that's in his way, so he had it moved by putting on logs and had it moved to a different location.
Not a great southern name, no. Pettibone.
Pettibone, yeah.
How'd your kids get so tall? When you guys are just kind of more average height?
Yeah, very average.
Bill was taller.
Yeah. Bill was.
He used to be 8'3".
He was really tall.
We don't know. I think it's one of those prophecies of the last days, don't you think? The giants will be in the land. Wasn't there one of those prophecies?
I don't know, which 30 tall people on your side, Bill? Yeah, it must be where they got it from.
Buckets.
Because the linemen aren't tall.
But nobody's that tall. The Wilkins have some tall, but it's more like this is for, like my brother John.
Sunset on Mississippi.
So it's these bluffs that lovers leave?
Hey, don't know.
Lover's Leap.
Tell me your name.
Hannibal, Missouri. I'm a Mark Twain.
Hey, Lord.
What?
Fly.
We want to know if we can have the what I was wondering.
I don't know if they're on a timer or something.
I saw it on before.
Probably want to ask.
Go squeegee it when it's done. See something to turn it on right here. If it's on a timer, then it's not going to do a whole lot of good.
Type of equipment he has. No, look over here. Mary, make her look over here. Lean back so I can see Tiffany a minute. Tiffany! There you go.
I'm in the next one. Right. So, guys. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Bend down there a little bit, Mason, so I can see the rest of them. Hey, you in the back, step out. Oh, yeah, you little guy. Well, you guys look like the James gang here.
You look pretty cool.
Who's that pretty school marm you got in front there? Yeah, you with the Jim Beam bottle. I don't know about this Holmes family. Carthage Jail, Illinois.
Tried to help Joseph and hire him all I could. This room is very original. As you see the floor, this is made out of native oak. And if you look carefully at those nails that are hammered in there, those are the old square cut nails. This is the same floor. It's been here ever since the jail was built, 39. Doors are original. The door you came in and both of the doors in this room are the original doors. They're made out of walnut. That too is a local wood. So that everything in this jail except the glass. When they first came to the jail, remember I said Joseph and Hiram were the only ones that were being held. And so Joseph and Hiram came to jail, but they had eight friends with them. So when Mr. Stiegel opened that front door and looked out there, instead of two people, there were eight people. He did what anyone would have done. He brought them upstairs and put them in the biggest cell that he had, and that, of course, was in the dungeon room. Well, they really didn't want to be in a dungeon. They wanted to be someplace where they could read, write, carry on business. We had the leadership of the church here in jail. They were trying to arrange for their defense. They really didn't want to be in a dungeon. As soon as Mr. Stiegel got a little bit acquainted with them and got to the place that he was not uncomfortable with them, he knew who they were. And he asked them if they wouldn't like to go downstairs and stay in that little small cell that he walked through, because at least they could see. So that's where they went, and that's where they spent the first night. 10 men slept in that cell the first night they were here in jail. They sent 3 more away from the jail on various errands. But by then, the Carthage Greys, the local militia unit, was guarding the jail. And as their friends left the jail, then they would not let them back in. In fact, they drove them out of town and some of them pointed their bayonets. And so, by the afternoon of martyrdom, there were just 4 men in this room. William Richards and John Taylor, and of course, Joseph and Hiram. Now, we have a dramatized tape. Actually, it's not a tape. We're very modern. It's a CD that I'm going to play for you. It dramatizes what happened here. It takes almost 4 minutes to play. But Woodward Richards, who was the only man in this room that was not wounded, said that he thought the mob was here for 2 minutes. He said they roared in like a tornado, and then if you listen listen to the tape carefully, you'll see why they left quickly, too. And so as we listen...
Elder Peterson talking about how to hire him. But his brother Joseph always had his arm around.
Thank you.
What do we call us, Bill?
The Grand Poobah Suite. Biggest one, the biggest hotel room in all of Nauvoo.
And what are you?
Grand Poobah.
Okay.
I'm waiting for the ladies with fans to come. That guy showed up with a gray poupon, yeah?
Well, you turned off my background music. It's okay. And the pizza, taco pizza we had today for dinner.
Almost fell over the edge there.
Yep, I ought to go videotape Pam and Rick's room now.
I don't know that we can get it that cold, you know, to condense that much.
It's around the corner.
Comes from the street.
Okay, all right.
Barley and Hot. There's Main and Hot.
Yeah, it's right there. It's all right there.
Can you tell what went on with the drugstore? Just a little history
Joseph
about that.
Joseph Smith's store, where the Relief Society was organized.
A lot of art about it. All the types of things they did.
But that's on
they
the
used in those days.
And the family.
To reorganize
it. Well, Edith, I think you'd be just the one for that job. You probably
that
knew all the stuff before you even got
sure.
here.
Yeah, always on
well,
earth.
There's a,
that
there's
you've
a couple
done
that lives upstairs
ago.
In that line.
They passed the number
there
four
are?
Test, too.
Well, how come you didn't get to live there if you had to get there?
Oh, golly, we didn't want to live upstairs.
I see. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We've got the ideal situation for us.
What is it that you've got?
We've got a motel room over there. There's four couples living in this motel.
Now, where's?
Where it's over on
Forest.
Is it up in this
we
section
of
town, though?
It's about halfway up the hill.
Oh. But it's a real live motel.
Well, yes.
Here's the Nauvoo Bell carriage here. How do I know that? Says it right there. Bell of Nauvoo, rather.
Thank you. I didn't want to miss the ride.
Liked it, found it to be a good one, and then so the Relief Society was organized. It's the largest women's organization in the world for the longest period of time. That little home was restored by the Relief Society, and also all of the finances that went into it were contributed by the Relief Society. Sarah Granger Kimmel was a very special lady. She worked very diligently in organizing groups to make clothing for the temple workers so that the work could continue, be a continuous thing at the temple, and many other things like that. That also was the city of commerce over there when Prophet Joseph first came here to church, but had to have been a very good and tender-hearted man. She was a kind of a real estate, dealt in real estate. Had a lot they were using to build these beautiful homes. Most homes were brick, pretty much. No, a lot of that was not. There's a brick work to keep up
with all of the fancy.
Yeah, yeah. Oh. He was the second president of the
home.
Church. Also, he was a great carpenter, built most of that home himself. If you'll notice, say that the temperature in that fluctuate just a few degrees, the difference between summer and winter. Great design on that.
Too late now.
I can get off.
Thanks for going.
It was great.
Have a fun time.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Come in just a little bit, honey, right to the edge of the deal. Lisa, right to the edge of the thing. In just a hair more. Whoop, back that way, right there.
And that building became Joseph Smith Sr. and Lucy Maximus' house. They lived in there for only for also down here at our feet here, at the corner of the street here, there's a small pyramid-shaped stone. That's original novel from copies written on the survey stone. Not very impressive to look at.
Nauvoo House. It's been designed to hold 300 people. Never completed. Mississippi River.
Also, kind of interesting on Water Main Street, rather interesting because.
Pioneer. Cemetery, Nauvoo. Really peaceful here, gorgeous.
There was one time when you were gone. But the first time you were there.
Find a place. Come on. Everybody's getting in. Bryce is taking
it. I'm doing
don't you two go away. We want you in the picture.
Don't you claim relationship
in there,
yeah,
we'll take him. We'll take him.
Drivers ought to be adopted.
Oh, Jake. So it looks like it's going all the way across. It looks cool.
Like this?
Yeah, Lavelle put his hand down. Jacob, your fingers down just a little. There you go.
There.
That's the long arm.
discount.
Well, you can wait till they get off.
Yeah, but see, what I give them is the making of this picture.
That's true.
No pinching.
Hold on.
That is a Christmas card picture.
At least that size. But I don't need all that. I'm above the top of the picture. No.
Hey.
Some of the cousins go bad.
Matt, that Matt's one? Well, it goes to, like, 90.
Right.
What that is, it's the same picture they just copied.
You want your feet?
No, I don't want you to go back that far.
You can focus it in.
I want you to get the...
There's a button on that'll go in and out.
Yeah, we're second-class citizens. We're by marriage, right? By
marriage. Here we are at winter quarters. Nebraska. New visitor center under construction. This is the Pioneer Cemetery.
Five of them, the names are on the plaque in front of you there, and you may have some ancestry there, I don't know, but as you look at those names, the ages are behind the names. They are in alphabet order.
Lack of vitamin C. Remember they left Nauvoo in the middle of February, in the first part of February in 1846. Did not have fresh fruits and vegetables. And by the time they got over here and got them, where they could grow anything,
messed up their arms. They get cankers in their mouth so bad that their teeth were loose and they couldn't eat. And they would, I think basically, they would starve to death because they couldn't eat.
They're 69 on the railroad.
So they're checking
it
out.
That was when the Golden Spike was driven in the Colorado. So they went by August. So then they went by rail. They didn't use the hand car to the wagon to put them on.
but there was about 6,000 that died during that period.
How that would take the car back?
Wagon, and she tells about how they were so excited to have this baby, her and her sisters, because it was such a source of comfort to them. And when the baby became sick, they were just frantic because they did not know what to do. And she enters in her journal every day for a few days, and it's in that big Lyman book, the orange one. And she tells about them trying to figure out what's wrong with this baby and how helpless she felt. That baby just kept getting weaker and weaker, and there was nothing to do. And then the day the baby finally died.
Is everybody doing okay with money?
I'll take some.
Except for I don't feel sorry for any of them. But.
Put your hand in
it out. You want to spot me a couple? Anybody that owes more for education loans than I do, then I feel sorry for. But.
Anyway.
Any of the kids whose parents aren't here, if you're having. If you're getting along money or something, let us know. We don't want you starving.
Won't give you any, but let us
know. Just let us know.
And we'll spot you some bread. We'll
let your parents know about it.
We'll spot you some bread and milk.
No, just let us know if there's problems. Okay?
Because the homeless people that stay homeless will take you and feed you.
All right, let's do
that. Not going to spot a buddy. We don't know what they will do with it.
The haircut that Ed has. Jeremy was telling me that's his new haircut.
What was your favorite part?
Where you just cut his hair that way?
Carthage?
Oh, yeah.
Carthage was the best.
Hey, they told us that we can get in the pool early if the morning people have no objection. So what we'll do is get up in the morning, check with them.
How early is that?
9.
Oh, the people that work here. Right, Chris, you can catch all the spit.
Doing his famous routine, and we decided that if we're going to get kicked out of this place for being loud, we're going to do it right now before we get thumbtacked.
Yay!
Well, I've got to get my gadget up. That's a lot of work. Okay, you ready?
You
got to psych up for this a little bit.
He's got his shoes on backwards. You got no shoes, Mary.
All of this is the first thing you used to do on your mission, right?
Yes, I used to do this on the mission, not quite this extreme, to try to get so I could get back to teach a discussion.
Weren't you there before they left Nauvoo?
Well, I was okay down there. They figured any Mormon that was that crazy, it was like Indians, it wouldn't hurt you. She's bad news. Ready? Okay.
Oh, Fi and I went to the circus weeks ago. So we bolted into the big sideshow. Then there we saw kangaroos, a monkey, then an elephant too. Then in the corner, we saw a two-headed cow. Oh, Fi reckon he know how that cow come to have an extra head. That's what Fi said. And then we heard a terrible noise. So we ran out the side to see what the noise was. And there we saw a big balloon and a man going higher than the moon. Oh, I thought that man would certainly get killed. So he ran off in my nails. Oh, Fi got his foot caught in the rope. And so did I. Stand up when I. South Hill youth be getting pretty high. Fi took out his knife and cut the rope down to the clouds. Heckity bent. We let right in that man. big, so tense. So the man, he wanted to know how we'd gotten his soul. We had paid a dollar apiece. And Stubbs, if he wasn't gonna get the police. Oh, sigh. The broke into a terrible rage. See back up against the monkey's cage. The monkey, the little cuss, got rattled at the fuss and grabbed Sly by the beard. Sly, come on, where is Sly? Sly couldn't stand for the crowd to scoff. So out with his knife, then he whacked his beard off. No more to the circus will we roam, nor will Sly, nor will I. Then if we do, I hope we die.
Did somebody teach that to you?
Oh, I don't know. I think it was always there.
I know.
I probably did this in the pre-existence. That's why they sent me here.
Well, you haven't been doing it enough.
Well, I'm glad because I've had.
That takes
a lot of energy.
Yeah.
But that?
Takes a lot of energy.
It's hard on me anymore.
Getting too old.
Huh?
Getting too old.
I guess. I run out of wind playing the harmonica.
Have
Let's go. We're going to have a word of prayer before we go. Fred, did we ask you to pray yet?
No.
The best shopper award. Now, why did she get this?
Hey, Lynn!
She wrote this down, it goes to
Irene. Yep, that's true, because every time I saw her, she was hurrying along with these bags.
I knew where to go this year.
And she was coming back with bags and bags.
Bags and bags and bags. The biggest eater award.
James Paul.
James Paul. Electrocutionist Tallest Tale Award.
I was
eloquent.
Those who wax elephants more than anybody else. Bill Landreth Sr. for Toledo, Milwaukee, Ohio.
That's a very polite way of saying the biggest fan.
What I have never said, I have never said.
And it's just as
it's
well.
All true. Vote Republican and vote often.
Memoirs for $49.95.
Now this next one is a play on words. The most talkative to Mike Bernhardt, who we think hasn't said two words. The most photogenic goes to Wendy. The Best Bouncers Award to Pamela and Lisi.
Yay!
Cindy and Jill.
It says Cindy and Jill. How did I get
that? Bob and I are going.
What? Look on your left.
Oh my gosh.
Semi. Officer Road.
Somebody didn't hit the brakes. Wait a minute, Ron's going to tell you.
He was asleep.
He was asleep and forgot.
Probably over the wheel, and he was having a dream.
Left the truck running.
Yep. And he got in and just popped into gear and slammed it on the floor and went over the
wheel. Popped into gear during this dream and pushed on the steel and over he went.
Hey, I'm giving my award back. Ron deserves it.
Hey, now you clarify that bouncer thing.
I'm going to go back to the bouncer.
Nobody is making miles as me and Pat. I'm going to check it out.
Well, I don't know how I got it. It says Cynthia and Jill.
We don't want to be in the same class as those mean old blisters.
Yeah, right.
The most positive person. This is another play on words.
Ron Perrin!
So this one is Eli Nielsen. Oh, yeah. Having the most upbeat attitude all the time. Another play on words. The Water Conservation Award. For the shortest shower. Yeah. 1.5 hour shower.
That's why there's no water.
I don't know what this next one means.
Take them off it and bring a friend. That's what I
mean. PMS award.
Well, just give it. We all know what it means.
To Ron Kern. Why did he get that?
What's PMS mean?
Why did he get that?
He's moody.
Because he's moody. Because he was in such a good mood at all the different places.
Yeah, because of his mood swing.
Because of his mood swing. The Polly Pleasant Award. To Mary, Caroline, and Diane. The Weird Lady. To Pamela.
No!
Go up there and rebut it.
She's crushed.
She's crushed.
She isn't going to say it.
I want to say something.
Beauty.
Pam, you better say something.
Academy.
And the Prozac that has taken it as well.
All of her sisters, thank you.
My mother, thanks.
Medication.
The most intelligent.
My mother, thanks you.
The most intelligent question, where does this?
I don't know.
Who is it?
Because she asked
the most intelligent question goes to Kristen Eakin. See how humble he is. He says, oh, it was nothing.
What was the question? She always just asked questions that were in touch.
We don't know. The Medical Emergency Award.
Lauren.
The Lauren. That all? I think that's all. Did we all get an award?
You did.
Well, I think some of us
did.
Bill Jr. The tallest award goes to Bill Jr.
Speech!
He gets an award for going back to his childhood, pretending like he's one of them.
Yeah, well, you ought to say that, Matt.
He gets the best going back to his childhood award because he is back there with the children.
More luxurious.
I think that's all the awards.
You want to tell them about the cemetery?
There we are at the airport getting ready to leave. Heading home. An arduous week. Not leaving Brian and Amanda, leaving tomorrow with us.
Strip searcher. Darn.